Hello, I'm Fast Lawyer. Today we're going to do a Let's Play and Initial Impressions review for Conductor, Creative Joy Engine, which just released on the Steam Store out of early access yesterday, March 26, 2022, for the HTC Vive, Valve Index, and the Oculus Rift. It's free to play, but it does have paid DLC if you want to support the developers. You don't really need the DLC. I think it just adds a couple more effects and all. And I have to be honest, I played this Conductor prior to release out of early access, maybe like a year, maybe 2 years ago, I forget. And I didn't notice much difference between now and getting out of early access besides the paid DLC. And I think they removed some of the content from the free-to-play version. So I'm not too happy about that. But everything seems to be the same. Probably the biggest... By the way, this is a music visualizer. The cool thing about this app is that you can also copy and paste videos. And that's actually what I'm doing right now. So you can play your own music. You can play your own MP3s. And I've done that. But the cool thing is you can also paste any music video from YouTube and then experience it here. I did have to fiddle with the advanced controls, and that's my main problem with this experience, is that the UI is very ugly. It's not very intuitive. It's not easy to use. If you want something as simple, just, you know, put your music in and chill, relax, that's not going to happen with this app, because you do have to fiddle with the UI and try to get it to work. Even when it works, though, and I think I got it to work, it just... doesn't react to the music as much as I'd like. So let's go ahead and let's just play. So I have something that I imported from the video, Tool Schism. And then you click on playback controls. And then we're gonna go all the way back to the beginning and we're gonna play. Now to get this effect, I did mess with the advanced controls. And so you can see you leave it blank. If it's on video, it's right now it's on video, so I leave it blank. But honestly, sometimes I took out away the X and put it back on, I didn't notice any difference. So let's put the volume all the way up, sorry. And to get this, to get it to look this good, I did mess with the advanced mode. Because otherwise it wasn't really reacting at all. Even then, it doesn't really react the way that I want, you know. Sort of reacts to the music, but not always. Like right now it seems to be doing fine, but for a little while before the music picked up, it wasn't really following. This is free to play, so obviously I do recommend it, but I have to give a warning now to anyone who's thinking about downloading this, how difficult the controls are. The UI is very unintuitive, and just selecting items from the UI can be quite the hassle because I often have to double click, triple click just to get it to work. And it's just a very ugly UI, very difficult to work with. Very unintuitive controls. It shouldn't be this difficult to get the reactions that you want, get the visuals that you want, get the music that you want. But it is in this app. But it is free to play, so you know you can't complain too much for free. As far as the visuals, you know, I do like the visuals. They're very trippy. You can definitely get in a trance while you're listening to your music. But again, I'm not a big fan of how it reacts to the music. Now, there might be a way to make it more pronounced, but if there is, I haven't figured it out. And by default, it was a lot worse than this. I had to mess with the controls quite a bit to get it to look even this good. And even then, I'm not happy with all the pink that shows up. It, you know, there are several times within the screen transitions where it's just a solid pink color. And it can be quite uncomfortable when it's just that bright and a single color in VR. Like right there, you see the transitions there, and I would like to switch up colors, you know, make it not just pink, but I haven't figured it out. And it's still showing my MP3 here versus showing that I'm playing the video. So I don't know what that's about. I don't know if I did something wrong. I will put a link on my video where you can download this. I think it is reacting to this music video. Again, this is on YouTube streaming. Sometimes it doesn't stream very well, but right now it is. And yeah, I do recommend it. And like I said, it's free to play. I'll put a link on my video where you can download it. And if I have to rate it, I'd give it a 6.5 out of 10. Biggest reason for such a low score is just the UI and the unintuitive controls. If that were fixed, I'd rate this higher. But yeah, I mean, it's good. You can listen to your music or listen to music on YouTube, and I think that's pretty good for a free app. And you get some pretty chill, pretty trippy audio visual effects. Pretty cool. Anyways, I'm Fast Lawyer. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And as always, have a wonderful day. Goodbye.